So I was spring 2017 graduates for the nonprofit Safe Haven International Bar. I apologize for this first name. I do not know how to do it. Faluke, yes. Faluke, come on. Bolt Bennett. Neil Berry. Joseph Brown. Selena Brown. Sherry Brown. Dawn Bruce. Pamela Bryan. Charlotte Copeland. Maria Dalton. Chaplain Kim S. Ilanio. Makia Ellis. Erica L. Ewing.
Pizza.
Katrina Fletcher. Pastor Patricia Gale. Garcia, Chaplain Alicia, Alex, Delmar Green, Michael Green, Denise Walden Green, Jennifer Johnson, Jennifer Johnson, Nicole Johnson, Evangelist Carolyn Lee Jones, Lizette Martinez, Hector Frosty, Sarah M. McGillis, Medina, Michelle Mendez, Dr. Aaliyah Morgan, gentlemen, so many releases. She had a family member pass away in this past week, so she was unable to be here. Let's keep her in our thoughts and our prayers. Yes, and so Pastor Tim is going to come up now.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Congratulations to all of those who are graduating. We're certainly proud of you, and I happen to know that the work that you are embarking upon is necessary. I was reading the scripture, and the disciples, they were looking out at the fields, and they were ripe for harvest, and somebody said, "Oh my goodness, the harvest is in trouble." But the master said, we need to pray for laborers. The harvest is what it is, but the laborers are few. Say amen, somebody. Right? And so you're being commissioned, you're being charged to go out as laborers. You don't want to take your certificate and put it on the wall, but you want to add some feet to it and make a difference. And that's what this organization, that's what this movement, that's what this Safe Haven Network is all about. It's about making things happen, changing people's lives one person at a time. And we certainly don't want our voice to be muted. We don't want to be beholden to anyone. We want to be able to speak truth to where truth needs to be spoken. Say amen to that, right? And so you need to know that we have not been granted any government money, any money from special interests. Everything that you see happening is out of the depths of our heart, right? And it's just people being moved upon with compassion to say that this is important enough to support financially. And so I'm the guy that gets to come up and say, "Hey, listen, we need you to give today." Pastor Harper is going to have the basket, and whatever you can give to help move this forward. The dreams that my wife has and the visions that God has given us to go even further is going to require money. Somebody say money. That's why it's not a four-letter word.
And it's a five-letter word.
Church, right? And it's being used for the furtherance of the betterment of the people. It's about changing people's lives. And as we graduate today, what a great opportunity for you to be able to give. Don't think that what amount you have is too small. Everybody participating together. One can chase 1,000 and two can put 10,000 in flight. And certainly when we work together, we can make a difference. Is that okay? And we don't want to feel like we have to be controlled and become puppets. I mean, that's what happens is you know, when you become beholden to a certain individual or a certain organization, they can start to pull your strings. You understand that? Amen. So we want to be able to march when we need to march, and we need to be able to change policy when the policy needs to be able to be changed, and we need to be able to speak what needs to be said. And we don't have to worry about, oh, if we say this, then somebody's going to be offended, right? Because we're going to support this ourselves. Say amen to that, somebody. I said, we're going to support this ourselves. Amen. We're going to watch that thing change. And so, we're going to recess out, but if you don't mind, I know this may not be standard protocol, but would you just come while the pastor's standing there? Would you just come on from your seat, just come in and place in the basket, whatever it is that's in your heart, to place in there, and then turn to your seats, and we'll go out and order fast. So would you do that right now really quickly? Thank you so much for your generosity. Thank you for your help in moving this forward. We never charge for the events that we have. We don't charge for the training that we give. This is all free will. God bless you. Thank you so very, very much for your generosity. God bless you as you do this morning. God bless you. Thank you. Okay, take a picture of that, because the world needs to see that we support the things that we believe in. That's right. We support what we believe in. We're determined to make a difference. And so as you return to your seats, there's two other quick announcements before we march out. But I just want to say thank you so, so very much. To see you come and respond is wonderful. God bless you as you do that.
So before we dismiss everyone, we have And so for our closing remarks, we're going to welcome back to the stage, number two.
Part of our next cohort, those that are here. But right before I close out, I'm going to ask Chris James to come. He is our Bronx Borough Director, and he has a special call to men, if he can come quickly. And then I'm going to have our recessional of our graduates first, followed by those that are attending.
Good afternoon, everyone. Congratulations. Awesome. My name is Minister Chris James. I'm the Bronx Vice Chair. And I just want to say that I am, most of you know my story by now, but I am a survivor. I was a victim. I was a survivor, and now I'm a survivor of sexual abuse and domestic violence. When I first started, and I was very lonely because I looked over the audience when I spoke and I didn't see the men. I'm happy today. Because more and more, the men are standing. All the men, all the brothers are standing. That excites me, and it's the numbers of men are growing. Nothing against you, ladies. We need our men, and this is a call to men. You know, one of the common words I heard all day is that word voice. And we have a voice, and we cannot take, I don't know how you feel, but even though I present sometimes what I feel murdering my sisters, I've got to tell somebody else. We are now responsible and accountable to tell other men that there's hope. You know the men around you may not know their direct story, but you can now have a deeper sense of understanding just by looking at them based on their now newfound intellect into human trafficking, how to respond. You have a response. You have to respond. And you have to respond by bringing more men into the program, but bringing more men hope in your own communities, in your own churches. You can't be silent anymore. Your voice has to be heard. So this is a call for you to rise up. You are empowered. You are now educated. You are now challenged. And you are now accountable to spread the word that there is hope. A lot of men are ashamed and they're hiding and they're silent. But they're dying and it's affecting their families. It's affecting their houses of worship. It's affecting their communities. You are now the light on that troubled sea that can lead them to safety. So I challenge you today, don't just sit still. We need to shout. Shout it from the mountaintops. Next time we have a session, and next round of training, we need to see more men. And it's going to be because of your outreach. God bless you all. Thank you.
Thank you so much, and we're about to have our procession, and I just want to make some last minute announcements. Basically, we have a few announcements that we want to make. I think it's the next one. First of all, definitely continue to follow us on Facebook and Twitter at Not On My Watch NYC. Also, the handle is hashtag Not On My Watch NYC as well. I also encourage you to go to our website, shnintl.org, and sign up for our next class that's going to be taking place. I know we have Mount Vernon, Long Island that's being launched, but we also have Harlem coming up towards the end of September into October. There'll be three all-day sessions that you'll be required to attend and be among those that have graduated just as today. In addition, you can create your own and come to us and let us know. We would love for you to come to our organization, come to our house of worship. We have spoken to parent advocates in schools, and so if you desire to have that, we can do that as well. But we do encourage you to come through our classes. In addition, we have a trip that's coming up to D.C. Being hosted by U.S. Senator Gillibrand. We leave on Sunday, October 1st, and we will be with them on Sunday, October 2nd. We're also inviting other officials as Hakeem Jeffries, Charles Schumer, and all of our U.S. representatives to really talk about this issue of ending violence against women and children. And we would love for you to be a part of that. There will also be a tour of the White House for those that have never been there. And while we know the foundation is very shaky, we don't run from the darkness, we confront it. Because we are people of light, and people of light dispels darkness. And so we plan to hit that head on. In addition, it shows that if you want to, please write down our information, stay in contact. Stay in contact, the numbers are given there, as well as the email address of info@shnintl.org. And you can call us at 646-844-4SHN for SHN. Again, thank you so much for coming. I want to thank all of the borough directors and then all of the vice chairs for being here. Thank you for Meta for being in your place. Chris and Susan Gambler, she had to be with us a little bit late, but she has been an instrument. Would you stand, Susan? I need to acknowledge you. She's our vice chair in Queens. She's been with us since the beginning. She's been away here, and we just want to know publicly how much we appreciate you. Thank you so much. And James Lickett, as you saw, that was standing here, he works in Manhattan. I'm going to ask my friend Chaplain Kim Osorio to come and give us a closing prayer. Right after the closing prayer, I'm going to have our graduates stand, and you're going to recess out. If you want to mingle for a few, that's fine. And then we're going to go upstairs to finish up our last minute details. Thank you again, everyone that's come to support our graduates. We really, really appreciate it. And thank you for joining us. I neglected to announce, as you saw this little bunny rabbit running around with this camera in her hand, she is an amazing photographer. We just had our 4th annual national conference regarding human trafficking and domestic violence in Brooklyn, where we brought together voices from Homeland Security, NYPD, the DA offices, service provider, grassroots organizations, etc. It was phenomenal. We do it every year. It's going to be the second Tuesday in June of next year. We would love to have you. I'm saying that to say this, that she did an incredible job of creating photography. Her name is Ebony Brown. And so if you would like to have family photos taken after this, she is available to do that directly after we're completed this session. So without further ado, I'm so grateful that my Bronxite sister has come up to join us and to be a support. We support one another, we love one another, we text one another, we encourage one another, we check on one another to make sure we're getting some self-care in the mix. And so I'm just going to have her come and give us our benediction, after which time the graduates will stand, being led by Dr. Teresa Lloyd, who is also, raise your hand, Dr. Lloyd, who is also our Manhattan Borough Director. So thank you, Dr. She's so glad to have her a part of the movement.
final note, we have material in the back. Please take it. I know Pastor Q mentioned it earlier. We would like to have you take this material. Don't put it in your closet. Take it to work. Take it to church. Take it to your family member's house. Take it to the beach when you go this summer. Give the people the information. Thank you.
To God be the glory. To God be the glory for the things He has done. I'm so very proud to be acquainted with my sister, Reverend Kimish, and this amazing movement under her leadership, and Chaplain Doreen Hussein and all the other directors and chairs. Wow. Wow. I was with her when she started. And to look to where it's grown, and to know that through you, greater is coming. Amen. Greater is coming. So I'd just like to congratulate you, all of the graduates. Congratulate those who received the Still I Rise Award. But all of you are rising. Hallelujah. You are rising to the challenge. You're rising to the challenge, and I'm so very proud of all of you. May God continue to use you for His glory.
Yes.
Amen. So, I didn't come up here to do all of that. Let us look to the Lord. Please stand. Hallelujah. My God, my God, my God. You are the Creator, who we call by so many different names. But we just want to thank you for all that was said and done in your presence on this day. And we give you all the glory and the honor, because we know that it is your strength that we have come this far by faith. And we will continue to look to you for guidance and direction as we go forth and we speak the prophetic word where it may not be wanted, but where it is needed. Lord God, we thank you. We ask that you continue to just speak to these thy people, walk with them and talk to them as they go forward. And as we leave this place, but never your presence, we go under your anointing, your guidance, and your blessing. And all of God's people together say, amen.
Now let's greet the graduating class of 2017 Spring Cohort as they exit from our sanctuaries. Yes, absolutely.